Well, now for something completely different, Agfopedia. I think one of our sort of best kept secrets besides Flow, compared to Flow and RSR. So really great to be able to show to share something with you. We're in the phase of, we did some work, I'll present shortly to you what we've been doing and our ideas towards the future. So specifically, the invitation for you all, if you're interested, share us in one of the next sessions to gather input, because there are links. We can put an immense amount of information in any wiki, but we should be thinking outside in and not inside out. So any creative ideas to be whether we could join and use towards a future agenda would be mostly welcome. But first of all, I'm going to tell you some show you some things that we've been doing. Yeah, I will. For those who are not familiar with Agfopedia, very shortly, some slides on how it's structured. Very simple way. A wiki, pages gathered in portal, a portal structure around water, sanitation, finance. So a very sort of simple, it's part of the entry page, a very simple entry for anybody who is looking for a specific information on a specific topic. And for instance, if you're looking for water related issues, you go to the next portal and then you see in a very simple pillar structure the main topics that are present in the wiki with icons you can click on, and you immediately jump to an individual article page on that specific topic. In some cases, depending on the topic, there's one level extra page in between, but the portal has in it max four levels, and the majority of the portal consists of three levels of information. The main page, the portal page, and within the portal page, the individual article pages. So that's a very simple, accessible navigation structure, which enables you really simply finding your way back and forth through the portal. I usually get lost in a lot of platforms, and after searching my way around for 5 minutes, I give up. So we really try to prevent that in the structure of Agfopedia. Wash focus, small and affordable and effective, affordable technical solutions, effective approaches. We started in 2007 with five articles, and we're now up May 2013 up to 800 articles as a whole. The all-time high most popular page is the well-known rope pump. It's still number one with, since the beginning, more than 38,000 views of the page. Perhaps some page views. Benchmarking figures would be really nice to have, but that's something hopefully for 2013. If you look at page views, you see the yellow bars is 2012. The blue ones, 2013, for the first 4 months. So it's the growth compared to 2012 have been significant. So we've more or less doubled the amount of page views, for instance, in April compared to April 2012. But there's also the growth is significantly. We're this month, let's say the average growth on a monthly basis is about 12% in both visits and page views. So apparently people are finding us more and more, which is, at least we have momentum that we can use to share information with. So in 2012, overall 1.1 million page views, and depending on the further development, but based upon the figures of the first 4 months, we will be more than doubling this. Now, naturally, related to page views, number of visits, more or less comparable. So in 2012, about 300,000 visits, and in 2013, 650,000 visits, of which unique, 380. So people are coming back. And I'll show some stats more in one of the next sessions. Majority of visits coming from the US, with India and Mexico and France competing for the third place. So more or less the same development regarding page views, more than doubling compared to 2012. So what have we been doing since, let's say, Q4 in 2012? We've been working with IRC on a new finance portal. I'll show something about that in the next session. We've just started also with IRC working on a new sustainability portal. We are working currently with RAIN. RAIN won a large IFAD grant on rainwater harvesting for food security. So with a part of this program is extending the rainwater harvesting section within Agfopedia. And I can very shortly show you that, if this doesn't work here. So the information within Agfopedia is grouped around three sections: on tools, on technologies, and the innovation pilots. And you can see we are in the middle of constructing these pages, and Agfopedia will be used as a platform to present all the additional article pages on rainwater harvesting. Together with a university from Sweden, we've been working on training material on sustainable sanitation that is presented within Agfopedia, both in PDF but also in PowerPoint. So anybody can download the whole program of all the individual slides, reuse those slides for your own specific training program. This is a huge, it's about 600 slides spread out over all sorts of topics, so anybody can use this. Currently it's being reviewed by Linköping, and we'll be presenting that in June also. So very easy, download your own PowerPoint, reuse material, and you have the sort of the basics for anything you can use for building your own course in a very simple way. Some decision support tools. There's a lot going on at this moment in various programs, either financed by the Dutch Wash Alliance, but also EU program on speed kits regarding emergency decision support tools regarding water, sanitation. So there are all sorts of tools currently under development. Also, IRC is working on financial decision support tools. We expect that at the end of this year, a number of the tools will be ready. They will be disclosed, they will be shown in Agfopedia, so that anybody can sort of dive into a specific topic and narrow down your options if you are struggling to find information on a specific topic. It's not the holy answer, but it helps you in finding feasible options. Some other things, the partnering position. We believe that our role as ACFO, we're not a knowledge creating institute. We are not a university. ACFO provides the platform, and ACFO innovates the Agfopedia platform. But we should be working together with content partners, helping to publish and disclose their information on a platform like Agfopedia. So we are intensively seeking more and more cooperation with content partners like IRC, like RAIN. But it also, to show you this, it's very easy to disclose an Agfopedia page inside your own website. You see here a dummy of the web platform that we are building, a part of the IFAD program. And very simply, basically what we've done, in the knowledge section, there's a link towards the wiki. And what you see is exactly the same page on rainwater harvesting within Agfopedia, but embedded in the platform that is specifically built for this program. So without the main navigation bar on the left, without the Agfopedia, specifically Agfopedia look and feel, this is simply the rainwater harvesting subsection presented within the web platform. So this way, it's very easy for a content partner to specifically take out one part, present it in Agfopedia, and present it in your own environment. Some new features. That's more on the technical side, a general update. Naturally, we're going to update to a new platform. There's a video, there's a video plugin, very simple, but could be powerful. Currently within Agfopedia, we only have a link to a video channel, but video itself is not embedded in the page. So it allows you to present some of your material or your contribution by shooting a video and present the video on the article page itself. A mobile app that enables you to export some article pages on your Android phone. And also another one that we're gonna build in, it's near ready, to be able to perform a live search from Agfopedia into a partner's database. For instance, the WASH library was part of the discussions with the finance portal. You can perform a live search directly from Agfopedia in the WASH library or any connected library of a partner. So what we are looking towards the future with a question mark, model, content partner, a network partner, linking cooperation with other wikis website and the role of ACFO, providing and innovating the ACFO platform and delivering editorial services. This all sounds very technical. There is an idea behind this, and I see some people smiling already. I think it's a Dutch professor. A lot of people know his work on knowledge management, and I especially like the quote of our colleague Mark, who is currently in Indonesia providing float training. Nothing spectacular is a good theory. On the topic of knowledge management, we could have a separate session for days probably. And there are as many authors, as many theories. What I like about this one, it's very simple, it's very transparent, and it more or less reflects the two legs that we are trying to build more or less into Agfopedia. It's the information leg. That's all the information that is stored in a system in terms of article pages or documents or whatever. And there's the softer part, build upon personal experience, skills, and attitude. And is in the philosophy of Wegeman. Wegeman says you can put information in a system, but not knowledge. The combination of knowledge and being, the combination of the ability to use the information inside your head in a specific situation, the combination of the two, that's what gives you the personal ability to perform a specific task. So there's the, let's say, the human part, and there's the hard, explicit information part. This is what Agfopedia is about. But this is what connects people and what provides a sort of learning mode. Now, what we are doing, and that's for future discussion. On the information part, we are extending and diversifying the information in Agfopedia, but that's only one leg. It's about new article pages and portals. It's about decision support systems. It's about questions and answers. It's about project information and geographically referenced data. And what we are intending to build step by step towards the future is see how Agfopedia could support connecting people. Because if I go through a wiki and I'm looking for answers to a specific question, I scroll through pages, but questions remain. I don't find the specific answer exactly fitting on my personal situation. So that's only part of the story. It's also about connecting people, because talking to somebody might help you in finding the answers you are looking for. So what we are gonna work on is naturally the mobile app video linking to IRC Knowledge Point within the finance portal. There's a link to IRC Knowledge Point. IRC Knowledge Point provides a questions and answers system. So this is only for the finance portal yet available, but I think it's an example. If you have a question related to a financial aspect, for instance, on CapEx, capital expenditures, you can look from Agfopedia into Knowledge Point and see which questions have been asked related to that topic and what the answers were and who answered the question. And that allows you to contact that specific person. And then Agfopedia doesn't provide the answer. It only helps you in finding somebody who is knowledgeable at a specific topic. And also Agfo-RSR and Agfo-Flow. And why? So question mark. Could Agfopedia 2.0 being a place that shows you information? And that's more or less the current article pages. But that's only information. That narrows down your options. It helps you in finding out of perhaps 5 or 6 different hand pumps, it specifically on your situation, the decision support tool built into Agfopedia says, no, there are only 2 that you could reasonably use in your situation. But then you still don't have the answer. So related, for instance, to financial aspects, you might go to Knowledge Point and see whether financial aspects related to your choice have been discussed in this forum. Agfo-RSR might show you what does and what does not work. If you are able to access from those specific hand pump types the selection of the relevant projects within RSR where these hand pumps have been used, you get access to project updates, but more important, you get access to the involved partner network. So that will show you throughout RSR or any other project update system, it will show you the people who have been involved in the project or program network. So this is what we are step by step thinking about and trying to realize. Not building this huge, humongous system which tries to solve any question, that's nonsense. Agfopedia will stay a wiki. But the only thing that we're going to add is to the wiki, simple links providing you access to other places where you could connect to people and hopefully be able to find in a face-to-face or in a Skype or in an email or whatever, face-to-face contact with somebody who is knowledgeable at a specific topic. So it helps and doesn't provide all the answers. So this is basically the philosophy. Under discussion for the 2013 roadmap, and hopefully we are able to one way or the other connect to Agfo-Flow, providing you data, and to, for instance, Agfo-RSR or any other partner database that shows you specific, real experience, hard field data. So this is more or less the future picture under discussion for Agfopedia. Questions?
I was just wondering, I haven't used it at all yet, but is it like Wikipedia that anyone can edit it?
Yeah, exactly. It's open source. Anybody can edit it. The reality, to be perfectly honest, is that it's open.
So it's built in MediaWiki. It's exactly the same look and feel as you will find in Wikipedia. The reality is, if you want to edit, you should be able to use the system. So at a certain level, you need to be knowledgeable on MediaWiki as the platform to be able to produce, to write these article pages. So the reality, and that's probably the same with Wikipedia, out of every 10,000 visitors, there are 2, 3, 4 people contributing to an individual page. So that's also the challenge we have for Agfopedia. MediaWiki is working on a new editor. What you see is what you get, but it's not ready, which really makes it more simple to add content to the wiki because you don't need to be very skilled in using MediaWiki as the language for drafting these pages. So that's a threshold that we should try to get over by. So yes, take a look, and you will recognize it immediately as part of the Wikipedia family. And yes, anybody can contribute, and yes, it's all open for anybody to use or download or reuse any material within Ecfopedia. Yeah, there is within the partners and we are working on the various platforms, but that's a small, relatively a small team. About 5,500 people have access to the system, so they are in the position to contribute to Ecfopedia. The reality is that it's only perhaps in combination with our partners. On a more and more regular basis, about 30, 40 people contributing to the wiki, but that's about it. Sean Fury of the RWSN, the Rural Water Supply Network, is one of our more active contributors, but that's only a very limited number of people. That's the reality. Majority of the work is done by us, publishing the content that we get from our partners.
Do you marketing it any way, or people get to know it via your partners, or how do you want to make the editor base or the user base bigger?
Yeah, we made a very modest first step on World Water Day, because on World Water Day we launched the new finance portal, and that was part of the side programs on World Water Day. And that's also one of the very, very necessary actions for 2013. The reason why I said it's the best kept secret of ACFO. But yeah, to be true, on a daily basis, we have about 6,000 or 7,000 pages opened. So we are generating a lot of traffic to the platform. It's not very small. Any benchmark figures of any other wikis would be most helpful, but we have a lot of attention for a wiki specialized on WASH, which is a very, very focused topic. Yeah, absolutely. Marketing strategy is high on the list. Thomas wants to say something.
Last question. Sorry, Hans.
That's good. I get the last question, so that's all right. It's not actually a question, it's more of a statement. There are a couple of things that are interesting with the way the Ecfopedia functions. One is, if you look at the traffic, the visitors that come to the site, they often come from Google, they search for something and they come to the site. And one of the most popular pages is Deep Pit Latrines. And Deep Pit Latrines is not something you search on by mistake. So people come there, they read the page, and they often leave after that. In other words, they find what they were looking for. So they search for something very specific, they found what they were looking for. And every minute of every day, three pages on the Ecfopedia are displayed for somebody. So it serves a function. We haven't really pushed it very hard. One of the things that we've found a challenge is that it's actually branded under the ACFO site. So it's been sitting under ACFO.org/wiki. And some organizations find this a little bit difficult to contribute to because they feel that they don't get to participate in an equal way. So what we're doing now is we're splitting off Ecfopedia as its own domain. So ACFOpedia.org, because Ecfopedia as a name has established itself, people know what it is. So we're splitting it off to its own domain, ACFOpedia.org. You can still reach it through the ACFO website, but it will have its own brand, so to speak, because we think that's a better collaboration environment. So those are just a couple of thoughts we hope is going to help get more contributors. And then this, the whole thing with the portals as well, where you can start looking to brand part of the Ecfopedia with your own brand, but it's still the same core database, is also something we think is going to help.